Hi, welcome back to the Professional Development Series for Engineers. We're going to start a series of three presentations on effective oral communication. Today we're going to talk about planning your presentation. So in this set of three videos, we're going to talk about how you plan your presentation, how you prepare it, and then how you actually go about delivering your presentation. So important to realize that a talk is much different from a paper. You can't go into every little detail in a talk as you can in a paper. Papers are just much, much longer. So in a talk, what you do has to be presented correctly the first time. You can't go back and reread the hard parts in a talk the same way you can do in a paper. Similar to that, the speaker controls the pacing. The speaker also gets to choose what's important, what the speaker wants to emphasize, de-emphasize, how quickly you want to present things. In a paper, all this control lies with the reader, unless the writer is really good at using headings, subheadings, chapter titles, all those kinds of things. Here it's all about how well the speaker plans out the talk and chooses what to emphasize or de-emphasize. Now the first question people always ask themselves when being invited to give a talk is, well, what am I going to talk about? In reality, that shouldn't be the question. Even though that's where you want to go, first of all, what am I going to say? The question you really should be asking yourself is, why am I giving the presentation, not what am I going to say? So the reason why you might be giving the presentation varies widely. For example, you might be there to inform or instruct. You're presenting about your research, whether that's your undergrad research, grad research, at a conference, at a seminar, wherever it might be. The way you deliver a presentation about informing or instructing is different than if you're trying to persuade someone to do something. For example, I give a lot of presentations on encouraging people to come here to Ohio State. So those kind of presentations look much different than my research-based presentations. You might want to give a progress report where you're going to provide an update, outline your next steps, ask for feedback from the audience. You might be giving a job talk where the underlying context is, I want to work here and I'm better than anyone else you're going to get to come here and give the talk of their own, so you should hire me and not someone else. You might not be giving a one-way stream of information, it might be a two-way stream where you want to present your own information and then gather information back from the audience and gather a discussion. Or you might just be for entertainment. You might be there to tell jokes, to entertain, to kill time, whatever it might be. So it's not really what you're going to say, it's why you're up there giving the presentation in the first place. After you figure out why you're giving the presentation, you need to think a little bit about your audience. What level of expertise does your audience have? Do they all know as much about your topic as what you do? And they probably don't. So how do you include information where that everyone can learn a little bit of something and not only speaking to the experts in the room? You need to think about why your audience is listening to you. In a class setting, maybe they have to listen to you. They are forced to listen to the next person talk, and that's why they're there, because their grade depends on it. Or maybe this is at a conference and where people are legitimately interested in what you have to say because it is a benefit to their research, or they're your competition for their own research. What do they want to get from your presentation? Do they want to learn something? Do they want to see what you're doing perhaps incorrectly and provide you feedback? Are they there to try to steal your ideas? What are the goals of the audience in terms of what they want to get out of your talk? Then is the audience homogeneous or not? What's their level? Who's there? Range of experts, range of ages, experiences, all those things. So again, everyone should be able to understand something. Then what's expected of you? How much time do you have and how is that time allotted? This can vary greatly. For example, someone invites you to give a one-hour seminar. Typically, at least in my department, a one-hour seminar means we expect the speaker to present for about 45 to 50 minutes, which leaves 10 to 15 minutes for questions and answers. Most people assume this was the split. However, we've had a couple presenters, when asked to give a one-hour presentation, they spoke for 1 hour. So the one-hour presentation then didn't leave any time for questions and answers, so the audience was a little bit frustrated because they thought they were going to have the opportunity to interact with the speaker after the talk before the next group came into the seminar room. And this can especially vary at conferences. I know some conferences that give a 15-minute block in between speakers, but within those 15 minutes, you can have a 10-minute presentation with 5 minutes of Q&A, 12-minute presentation with 3 minutes of question and answers. So it really varies widely. So it's important, if you don't know, to figure out what's expected of you within the amount of time you have allotted for your presentation. then again for some other details. Are you presenting in a small conference room, or presenting in a large room, or a really, really large auditorium type of room where you're on stage? The amount of energy you would have to convey would vary greatly if you're in a small room in front of 10 people or in front of a large auditorium in front of 300 people. What type of room are you presenting in? How large should you make your slides? What kind of things should you bring in? Because if you're bringing around pass-around type objects, it might be great for a room of 10 people. 300 people won't be able to handle your demonstration in the amount of time that you can in a big talk. What time are you presenting? Are you presenting first thing in the morning? If you're presenting first thing in the morning, people are a little sleepy, still wiping their eyes, trying to get themselves out of bed. Are you presenting after lunch? If you're presenting after lunch, has a good old food coma set in, so people are sort of dazing off and not really trying to pay attention to you as much as they're trying to not fall asleep. I presented and taught class a lot of times through lunch, and people are snacking, or you hear their stomachs grumbling, wanting to get out of there as quickly as possible. Then plan for other details, such as does the computer have a room? Does it have a projector? Does it have a microphone? Does it have an internet connection? And for all those things, do they work? And do you know how to change the volume or change the projection or get to the internet? All those sorts of things you need to do while you're giving your talk. I always try to go a couple minutes early to make sure everything's working the way I would like to in the space where I'm going to be presenting. So while you're planning your talk, know what the purpose of your talk is, what the audience expects of you, and what their expectations of you, and what you're allowed to do in the amount of time you have available. When and where are you presenting? Does everything in the room work? And do you have all your needed equipment? Thanks for listening to Stage 1. Now I'll go on to Stage 2 of the video.